Naham ijya prajapatibhyam. Naham ijya prajatibhyam. Tapaso upasamenava. Tuseyam sarvabhutatma. Guru sasasayajatha. Naham ijya prajatibhyam. Tapaso upasamenava. Tuseyam sarvabhutatma. Guru sasasayajatha. Sisila Bhakti Siddhanto. Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, today Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, today is the appearance day of my Gurudev. Everybody is speaking, today is the disappearance day of my Gurupad Padma. But I find today is the appearance day of Guru Pad Padma. Exactly, I am speaking rightly. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking this way. Why? Because Prabhupada want to prove, then when Guru Pad Padma take leap from this material world, then he take permanent seat into the heart of a pure devotee, pure disciple. Actually, when Guru Pad Padma disappears from this material world, he can make his permanent seat into the heart of a pure, dedicated soul, Shishya. A Guru Pad Padma never make any disciple. Prabhupada speaking, Guru Pad Padma, Sadguru, never make any disciple, always make Guru. How? Any disciple who is not up to the level of Guru Pad Padma, he is not servant. He cannot serve Gurudev. Krishna is staying in this transcendental planet. Gurudev there, Prabhupada there. If I am not elevated up to that point, I cannot serve. If there is disbalance, I am in this plane, material planet, material plane, is in transcendental plane. Until and unless I cannot make up this gapping, actually, perfectly, I cannot do Guru Seva. Not possible. Is the exact philosophy Prabhupada speaking. One Sadguru always making Guru, not making Sishya. That is the very thing, same thing, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Dikha kale shishya kare atma samarpan, sei kale krishna tare kare atma sam. Is exactly. When your submission is 100% perfect, then be sure at the same time you can get power from Guru Pad Padma readily. There is no doubt. There is no doubt you can get power from Guru Pad Padma. Though our Guru Bhargava speaking, Diksha is a long procedure. Why? Because at the time of submission, At the time of submission, our submission is not perfect, not saturated. Up to that point, you will have to wait. Whereas and when you can get that perfection, attain that stage, then you can start Guru Seva. Still, Haridas Thakur was speaking in front of Besha Pros that I am initiated every day. Why? Because my Diksha is not complete. When we go, when we can climb this transcendental world by the mercy of Guru Pad Padma and Prabhupada, I don't know. Then also we have the chance to do Guru Seva. Guru Seva is Nitya. Not that today we can do Guru Seva like Mayavadi and we can push Guru Pad Padma and throw him away. Not temporary matter. In Mayavadi Sampradaya, Guru Seva is temporary matter. For the time being I can accept Gurudev. And after that, when I can realize Brahma, I can throw my Guru away. But in our Gauriya Sampradaya, in Vaishnava Sampradaya itself, there is no such, you know, false philosophy. I mean, they are also doing Guru Seva, Guru Puja. You can find Sankaracharya Sampradaya, they are doing big Guru Seva, even more enthusiastic way than you. But their Guru Seva is kapat. they are actually, you know, false Guru Seva. They want to prove that we are doing Guru Seva. When you have no 100%, you have not 100% believe in Guru Path Padma, at the same time you are losing the mode of serving Guru Path Padma, because you know it is temporary. Guru Path Padma is not permanent. This way, actually, Prabhupada speaking, everybody is speaking, today is the disappearance day of my Guru Path Padma, but today I feel that today is the appearance day of my Guru Path Padma. Param Pujavat Keshav Goswami is speaking, appearance and disappearance for Supreme Lord, any avatar, and for Vaishnavas, all the same. Why? Why same? Keshav Goswami is speaking, suppose one circle is there, one circle is there, if you point out the original point from where you started and you wanted to complete the circle with compass, when you started, when it ends, all the same, it can come to the same point. Only appearance and disappearance we can speak, but it's all same. Why we speak that today is the, you know, Ananda Utsav, Biraha Utsav, whereas you are saying the disappearance of Guru Path Padma, you are feeling separation. At the same time you are speaking, today is the big Utsav, big feast and Utsav, we are, why? Because Keshav Goswami is speaking, this is a nice opportunity that Guru Path Padma gone to his eternal world, having his same place, from where he came back, he was engaged to, you know, give some treatment to us. We used to give him so much pain, but now at least he is relieved. You know, now he is enjoying his seva, nitya seva, his, you know, ishtadev seva. So in this sense, it is big utsav. This way, please believe me, today also I speak from heart. Today is the appearance day of my Guru Path Padma Srila Bhakti Shaudha Assam Goswami Maharaj. But you can protest readily, your Guru Path Padma is Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, why you are speaking this way? Your Guru Path Padma is Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, why you speak that your Guru Path Padma is Bhakti? Why you are speaking this way that your Guru Path Padma is, you know, Bhakti Shaudha Assam Goswami Maharaj? Actually, this Gauriya Darshan is very perfect darshan, very pure darshan. When I am going to pay pushpanjali unto the lotus feet of your Guru Path Padma, that pushpanjali automatically going to the lotus feet of my Guru Path Padma. This is actually fine philosophy, fine darshan. No common people, they cannot realize this point. This is Nitya Jagat, eternal world, where this kind of discrimination, disparity not possible. Yes, Advaita Gyan Tattva, you know, and Guru Path Padma also one unique tattva, you cannot break. All Sadguru Tattva coming from same unique point. So all Sadguru Tattva, you can speak this way. Today is the, you know, I am going to pay pushpanjali unto the lotus feet of my Guru Path Padma Srila Bhakti Shaudha Assam Goswami Maharaj. Because my darshan is not bad. Because I heard from my Guru Path Padma, I wanted to learn this thing, develop that kind of darshan, what's wrong with me? But one point is that everybody is shouting, we must give pushpanjali first. You know, in Haridwar or in Allahabad, when, you know, Kumbh Mela going on, they are fighting who can take bath first. They can kill, even they can kill you. If you are going to take bath first, they can kill you, they can take bath first. Police man, they have nothing to do with that. It's big issue. So here also, those who are blind people, they have fallen so, they think we can pay pushpanjali fast. They like to get some garland and pushpa, they have money in their pocket, they like to gather so much garland and pushpa, they like to give pushpanjali fast. But they are actually foolish, they don't know. Any amount of pushpanjali, any amount of garland is not sufficient to give pushpanjali unto the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava. It is not possible. You have money, you can purchase garland, what it concerns to us, but Guru Path Padma not going to accept your pushpanjali. I am going to pay pushpanjali to Srila Maharaj, Bhakti Soda Ashram Goswami Maharaj, or, you know, at the same time, I will have to wait whether I have my right or not, whether he allow me to give pushpanjali, whether he is ready to accept my pushpanjali. That is also a big point, big issue. Otherwise, big problem. Forcefully, I cannot do. Because transcendental world, there you cannot put your money power, your educational power, you know, manpower you cannot use. You cannot come out successful. This is big point. Actually, if we actual pushpanjali, what does it mean? One day Guru Bhargava teach me, my son, you see, pushpanjali mean to give your mind and heart unto the latest feet of your Guru Path Padma. Guru Path Padma is less interested about how much money you are going to give as donation, how much, you know, you are showing that I am doing seva for Guru Path Padma. It is not big issue. Actually, if you can give your mind and heart unto the lotus feet of Guru Path Padma, that is called actually pushpanjali. Because synonym of pushpa is suman. Suman Sarovar, you know? Suman Sarovar, you know? Kusum Sarovar? Kusum Sarovar means Suman Sarovar. Kusum Sarovar means Sanskrit, Kusum and Suman. Suman means also Puspa, flower. Nobody knows. So Guru Padma teach me, actually to give pushpanjali, meet to Suman, your good mind, pure mind, you will have to throw unto the lotus feet of your Guru Padma. Then you can say that today your pushpanjali is complete. Now, otherwise pushpanjali is not perfect actually. So actually, I have no right to speak this way that my Guru Path Padma, his appearance day or disappearance day, I have no right to speak this way. Why? Because how much sacrifice I have done in my life for my Guru Path Padma, how much dedication I have for my Guru Path Padma, that is a big issue. Otherwise, I cannot speak. I can prove that I am a big devotee, I am doing so much service of my Guru Maharaj. But how to detect that who is pure, you know, disciple, who is not? Because in Bhagavat, you know, Snigdhasya Sishyasya Gurava Gujjam Apiyuto. In Bhagavatam, you can get 10 canto, you can get this point. Snigdhasya Sishyasya Gurava Gujjam Apiyuto. Gurudev, he has nothing secrecy, which he cannot express in front of a pure, you know, disciple who is 100% inclined unto his lotus feet. He can unveil his heart totally. He can speak anything, any secrecy. He can give his total heart in front of that, you know, disciple. Like you know already, Madhavendra Puripad, he is from transcendental world, but his Ishar Puripad getting all power from Guru Path Padma. But Ramchandra Puripad not enjoying any power. On the contrary, he is going to find fault with Guru Path Padma and Vaishnavas. He want to find fault with Supreme Lord Himself. This way, we can grow this kind of propensity to find fault with Vaishnava if we commit aparadh. It's big issue. That's why my Guru Path Padma Srila Bhakti Pramod Purgishi Maharaj writing one book, Vaishnava Aparadh. Big issue. So if you can go through that Vaishnava Aparadh, you can learn everything. Now I like to speak something speciality of the Vaishnava today's disappearance day, Ram Navami Tithi. Actually he is a great Vaishnava. Nobody can identify who is pure Vaishnava, who is not. Prabhupada speaking, if you can discover that all the qualities of Gurudev, all the qualities of Gurudev coming inside the heart of Shishya, then be sure he is actual Shishya. Or on the contrary, some devotees can come and give garland to you. Still, you cannot say, I am actually a servant of my Guru Path Padma. This way, actually, Prabhupada speaking, if you can discover the, all the Siddhanta, all the Acharan, everything, from Gurudev, Shishya getting everything. All the total mind of Guru Path Padma, heart, transferred. And that time you can say he is Snigdha Shishya. He is actually pure Shishya. Pure Shishya means Guru. That's why I told you, Prabhupada speaking, a pure Guru Path Padma, Sadguru, never make any disciple. He always make guru. He never make disciple. This way, actually he was guru. Prabhupada, in his appearance day, ceremony, Prabhupada speaking, they are all sitting in front of me. They are all my guru varga. They are not my disciple. They are giving me 100% scope. All the time I am getting inspiration and scope to render guru seva, because they are giving me scope all the time to do some guru seva, Vaishnav seva, and you know, Krishna seva. I am getting chance. They are giving me chance. This way, Prabhupada claiming that they are all my guru varga. It is really 100%. Prabhupada not making any acharya. There can be 2 points. One is they are not at all acharya, and second positive point is they are all acharya. Whom to make acharya? This positive point is very okay. That's why. And negative point, if you think, you can think this way: if I make elect acharya, then everybody can start making acharya this way. Because I see everybody can act as acharya, because acharya self manifested. Nobody can make acharya through election. I told just 1 hour before. This way, Srila Maharaj was great acharya, big acharya. Though you cannot find so many disciples, 1 or 2 or some 4, 10 people. There is acharya, not big, but you are educated, graduate man, very nice personality, can speak fluently in Hindi, English, and you know, Bengali is very fluently. He was a big preacher. When actually he was so nice looking, actually people, they used to speak that he is second Swamiji. Swamiji mean in some ex-mission, you know, in ex-mission, you know, they are making one Swamiji. You know, you don't know, you should know it. Actually they make one Swamiji, but actually everybody is thinking he is like Swamiji, second Swamiji, you know, from ex-mission. You should, I can speak you after. After that, you see, he was very much, you know, attracted by their philosophy. Where very soon he get one magazine, Gaudiya magazine. Kirtanananda Prabhu and all devotees, they used to distribute Gaudiya magazine door to door. That time preaching was very typical. Now you can sit in one place and speak, and all and the whole world can hear you. That time it was not so easy. But actually, that time apparently he was attracted by the ex-mission. But where, as and when he get one magazine from one Gaudiya devotees, they are distributing magazine, Gaudiya magazine from Gaudiya Mission, Calcutta. So he was, you know, very lucky to get that magazine. The day he get that magazine, he readily open one page and started writing, reading about Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, they are writing. When he reading, readily he detect, this is not material writing. This speech, material people, they cannot speak this way. I am 100% sure this writing coming from the transcendental world. Even you can express, you know, you can go mad if you hear this point. Calcutta University, that time, 100 years back, Calcutta University, he was the acharya of Vasa language. So big acharya of language, Suniti Kumar Chattopadhyay. He was the big acharya of university. Not acharya in our sampradaya. He was a big acharya in acharya. He got title of acharya. Topmost man in language in Calcutta University that time, 100 years back. That time, when he got this Gaudiya magazine, when he started reading Gaudiya, he readily writing one letter to Prabhupada in Gaudiya Mission. The Prabhupada, excuse me, I thought so long, for long time, I am thinking I am big acharya of language. I am a topmost, you know, I am knowing topmost. Language is, you know, known to me. But when I read your language, I find I know nothing about what is language. I am not at all acharya, excuse me. So you will have to please, can you send your dictionary, Gaudiya dictionary, so that I can follow Gaudiya dictionary and find out the word. I cannot make any meaning of some words. But I know it is meaningful, but I cannot understand what is written there. Please excuse me. This way, he writing one letter to Prabhupada. From then, Prabhupada thought, I will have to make one, you know, Vaishnava Manjusha dictionary. Also, we know Gaudiya Vaishnava Abhidhan, we are getting from Haridas Baba. He was very polite man, big Vaishnava, though not from Gaudiya Math, but still he used to stay in Gaudiya Mission, Calcutta, and he got the chance to do compile this, you know, many, he is big Vaishnava actually. So this way, actually Suniti Kumar Chattopadhyay writing this way. So you know, big issue, a big point. So we cannot deserve that we know everything. That time, as and when he is reading Gaudiya, you know, Patrika, he really detect it is not material writing. Who is writing? He is not a material man. I never in my whole life and never heard this kind of language, this kind of power, bija, in this language. So I must find out who is the personality who wrote this way. That day when he read, he started searching. And he coming to Gaudiya Mission, Calcutta. He coming to Gaudiya Mission, Calcutta. Who is Prabhupada? Bhakti Siddhanta sir, I like to meet you. Meet him. You will have to wait. You can meet Prabhupada, but you will have to wait. After they meeting Prabhupada, when he look at Prabhupada, he really understand his... By appearance, Maharaj is half dead. Half dead means gone, consciousness gone. By appearance. And after that, he gave his whole life unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I like to do bhajan. Because as and when I write your, you know, writing, you know, hear your writing, I read, then I can understand that you are super personality. You are the, you know, coming from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Please bless me. Prabhupada, see, you can come that day. You can start staying with us. You try to know Gaudiya philosophy, then I can arrange. After that, Prabhupada giving Harinam, and very quickly, Prabhupada giving Diksha also. Prabhupada not giving Diksha so quickly. But dedication, how much dedication Prabhupada watching, is educated man, graduate, can speak English very nicely, so nice, so intelligent. He took birth in present Bangladesh, actually. So I have had the scope to write one book about him. Bengali. Chhattoder Bimala Prasad and Tatpriyo Bhakti, Tatpriyo Bhutabrit Prabhu. Bhutabrit was his Brahmachari name. That time actually, when Prabhupada giving initiation to him, after that, to test him, his dedication, Prabhupada really sent him to Puri, to actually Mayapur, and give the responsibility of cultivation to test him. You can go in so scorchy sunlight and take trouble to get protection of, you know, crop. You can collect crop, make, you know, sack. You can put in your, you know, bag and come. This way he is, you know, executing all responsibility as a farmer man. He is educated. He never doing anything. He has no connection with cultivation. But still, Prabhupada giving order. You go. Take responsibility in Mayapur Dham, all, you know, cultivation, you have to take responsibility. Then they making sack, and he educated man, putting in head, or big sack, and, you know, putting in, go down. This way taking trouble. Someday, some educated man coming from Calcutta, and he find one man is there, he's nice looking, very nice looking, fair complexion, and he asks something to him. Whenever he started discussing, he could realize he is an educated man. But why is that acting as a, you know, cultivating man? But still he started discussing. Then he is speaking in English, Gaudiya philosophy, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is just impressed. And some devotee informing Prabhupada, Bhutabrit Brahmachari is speaking so nicely in front of all educated people. They came to take darshan of Gauranga Dham. In Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is speaking with gamcha, no cloth. He is such a speaking so nicely. Prabhupada became very happy. After that, after testing, Prabhupada called him, come to Calcutta Math. After coming to Calcutta Math, Prabhupada said, can you take the responsibility to go to Madras for preaching? Prabhupada, if you order me, I can do? Because with order you can give power, I know. So he took responsibility. He going to South India, Madras, taking so much trouble. That time that field is completely negative field. Full of Sankar philosophy, full of, you know, big problem. Nobody can preach there. So hard place, dirty field. So he is taking trouble there, no room, nothing. So much trouble he took. After that, Parampujvat, Bhakti Doito Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Hayagya Brahmachari, he is Bhutabrit Brahmachari, and Goswami Maharaj, you know, Goswami Maharaj that time was, he was Brahmachari, Aprakita Prabhu, they are going there. Some of his devotee, you know, some of his disciple, sent by Prabhupada, they are expressing it more after 2 hours, 3 hours gone. It is quite impossible to preach here. Why you should tell? Then Hayagya Brahmachari and Bhutabrit Brahmachari speaking, I think up to now, our you know, positive effort actually not done. What do you say? 2 years we are fighting. No positive effort had been not done as yet. We will have to try again and again by the mercy of Prabhupada. Then they got one piece of land. Make one very small with tin, you know, shade. To manage to stay, protect from sunlight and rain, and started collecting money, this, that, I mean, preaching Gauriya philosophy. After that, getting some benefit, making small place, they started worshipping photo. Then they informed Prabhupada, Prabhupada, can you take the trouble to come in Madras? Because without you, preaching is not actually possible. Prabhupada writing one letter, that time no phone, nothing, no mobile. Actually, Prabhupada speaking, if you can at least make one small place for me so that I can put my body there, then I can go. It's possible because he is Acharya. All activities they can see outside people cannot understand. Then they are trying to make one small, very small room so that Prabhupada can come and stay there. Hayagya Brahmachari, all, you know, Aprakita Brahmachari, Bhutabrit Brahmachari, they are all trying, and Olvimi Maharaj also, trying hard day and night. One day, big, you know, rich man, he has a big influence in the society, inviting all sadhu. They don't know what is the explanation of sadhu, meaning of sadhu. They are inviting some from X mission, Y mission, and also from Gaudiya mission. They are inviting them. They get together one place. They are supposed to get prasadam after speech. They are speaking Harikatha. But ex-mission is also putting some influence. You know, samaj seva, society seva, they people, material people, they understand this much, very much. Medicine distribution, cloth distribution, so material benefit, they understand. They cannot understand the benefit of Gauriya Math. What benefit Gauriya Math can give, they cannot understand. Anyway, they are speaking the philosophy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. After the sava is over, they propose, now prasadam hall, you can go and take prasadam there. They say, Maharaj, we have no power to take prasadam. Why? From X mission, Y mission, everybody is sitting there, you see. They are big, big sadhu. They are taking prasadam. Why you cannot take? Then Hayagya Brahmachari and Bhutabgir were very humble mood. Actually, point is that they are big sadhu. They have their power to digest, you see, and meat and flesh, everything they can digest. But we have no power, very weak we are. Excuse me. They are powerful. That's why you please excuse us. If you have one or two fruits you can give, we can give honor to you, pray honor, you know, show honor to you, please excuse us. They, this way, they are kind to pass away. After that, actual preaching started, Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, then, you know, at present, I never been there actually, actually Madras Gauriya Math established, and then after on and on after that big Gauriya Math preaching going on. At present we need to go on those preaching field again and again for to revive the power put it by Prabhupada. Actually Acharan Prachar, both we need, otherwise we cannot come out successful. This Acharya, actually Bhutabrit Brahmachari, I mean, Bhakti Shauda Assam Goswami Maharaj, so powerful. While he is executing his order there, order of Prabhupada there in Madras, Gauriya Math, he was in charge. That time from England, one rich lady came. She is widow, with his very nice looking daughter, pretty girl. He has connection, because he is speaking in English Harikatha. He develops some kind of attraction for that Bhutabhrit Prabhu, Brahmachari. Someday he proposed, "My son, can you marry my daughter, nice looking, you know? Then I can give all property. I have billions of, pound I have in England. I can give all my property to you." He is giving proposal in front of Bhutabhrit Prabhu. Bhutabhrit Prabhu laughing. "Bhujya, I have so much big property. What Prabhupada giving to me? I never think that your property is more than this property. So please excuse me. I can treat your daughter, as my, sister. But I cannot marry. Please excuse me, mother. You can stay and hear Harikatha and try to understand the kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What kind of power, what kind of property we are enjoying, so that we can ignore the big property you are offering to me. Please excuse me." Vancha kalpataru vasya ke pasindu bhavacha patitanam pavanam avashtam vyo namo namah.